Good day everyone, Mr. Caraglio here with a next AutoCAD video. Now for this video, I'm going to show you how to complete this drawing here. Now this drawing comes from the topic reduction and enlargement of plane figures. So right here, we have a figure, this figure, A, B, C, D. And what we're trying to do is to reduce the size to get this figure right here, make it smaller. And also enlarge it to get it larger, like right here. So there are different methods. As you can see right here, there are three different methods that you can use for enlargement and reduction. We're going to start by looking at the direct method A in this video, and then I'll do videos on B and also the radial line method. Now for this here, the direct method A, for this specific figure, it says the drawing shows a quadrilateral where angle DAB equals 90 degrees. So this angle right here, DAB, that's 90 degrees. And it says AB is 45 and also CD is 30, DA is 20 and BC equals 40. So this is what we know. We know that this angle DAB is 90. We know that AB is 45 and AD is 20. So with that information, we can now start our drawing. So we are going to start by drawing a line here. Let me turn on ortho. So let me draw AB first. So this is A and this is B right here. I want to draw AB. Right? And AB is 45. So AB and that's 45. Good. And then I'm going to draw AD. And it says that AD is 20. So I'm going to draw this line 20 millimeters. So this line now is 20. All right. And then here it says that CD equal 30 and BC equal 40. So CD is 30 and BC is 40. All right. So knowing that CD is 30. All right. CD is 30. So from here to here is 30. All right. So I'm going to get a circle. I'm going to come to point D here, all right, and I'm going to make this circle 30 since CD is 30. So I'm going to type 30 and press enter. Let me just change the color of this circle to a dark gray color because it's a construction. And then it says that BC equals 40. So being that BC is 40, I'm going to select a circle again, construction line. And so I select a circle, I come right here to point B, and it says that BC is 40. So from there, I'm going to draw that circle 40 millimeters. All right, good. Now to get point C is right where the two circles meet. So I can complete my quadrilateral by doing this, by joining the points. Like I'll join D to C right here. Let me just turn off ortho. Join D to C right there. The two circles intersect, and to get that point, just ensure that you have intersection turned on in object snap. All right, ensure that you have intersection turned on and you have object snap turned on. All right, and then we join C to B right here. Ensure that you have endpoint turned on in object snap as well. Good. So there we have all our points. Yes. Now let's label the label. So let me just copy. Let me just copy these. Of course you wouldn't have had these written down already, so I'll show you how to write text, or if you don't know that already. So let me just copy, bring this over here to label this. Those are my points. Yeah. A, B, C, and D. Now for doing text, if you don't know how to do text as yet, you can just come over here where it says text, select a multi-line text, and then you just click somewhere to start and create a little rectangle by just moving your mouse like that. And then there you can type whatever you want to type, and then just click outside and you'll have your text right there. All right, wonderful. All right, so now there's a line here that goes through A and C. So let's draw that line and let's draw it in construction. So I'm going to draw that line from A through C. All right. So let me just zoom out a bit. From A to C, right here it says it's 36 degrees, and then I'm just going to continue that line all the way out. But in continuing my line, I don't see the little green mark to indicate that this is the same angle as that. That this is the same, this is the correct angle. So let me just click here, zoom out a bit and extend that here. All right, and if you're not seeing the angle, what we can do is this. We know that this angle is 36 because when you drew the line, so that the angle was 36. So that you can come here to polar tracking, click here. You can click the drop down or beside polar tracking, go to tracking settings, and right here, set this angle to 36. All right, and I'll show you what will happen once you set that angle to 36 and click OK. So now if I draw a line from C and I extend that line outwards, all right, whenever it reaches the 36, you're going to see that green line to indicate that that angle is 36 degrees. All right, and you can do that for any angle that you want by just putting that angle in your tracking settings in polar tracking. So we're going to extend this line out, no specific distance, about there should be fine. No, we're going to do the reduction first, all right? And for the reduction, it says that the ratio for the reduction over here is, it says, let the reduction and enlargement ratios be length of side be 3:5 and 8:5 respectively. All right, so 3:5, we're reducing it by 3:5. So that what that means is that AB, we're going to divide AB into 5 equal parts. And to divide AB into 5 equal parts, just type divide. And then click on line AB. It says enter the number of segments. You're going to type 5 because you want to divide it into 5. And then you see different division points come up there. Now, if it's like you don't see division points, just type DDP. And click on DDP type. And then you can click on any one of these that you want to use to make your points here, like I have. So I normally use that one. And then you can set the size. It's all right. It's not too big or too small. And then just click OK. Now, so if I was to number these, all right, this would be, A would be 0. So this would be 1, 2, 3, 4. And then B would be 5. So like they have over here. 1, 2, 3, 4, and then B is 5. So that's how it would be over here. All right, so I'm going to just number it so that we understand a little bit better. Let me just copy A, put it at all these different points, and then I'll just change the value to the numbers. All right, B and 5 would be the same points. So yeah, I won't label 5 because B and 5 would be the same points. So this would be 1 here, 2, three, four. Right, and then B would be 5. Well, let me label it so that remember what's what. 5 and B are the same points. All right, good. Now it says the ratio is 3:5 for the reduction. All right, so that means that our next for the reduction is going to start from here. Our figure is going to start from 0.3. So what I'm going to do is to click on this line, and I'm going to copy this line from 5, bring it to 3 right here. Then I'm going to click on this line DC. I'm going to copy it from where this line that I just drew intersects the line DC, right at that intersection, and I'm going to copy it and bring it to this point right here. All right, this point right here with the line from 3 means the line that goes from A through C, and do that. So now I have that point. So now I'm just going to click on this line and extend it up at the same angle. This little green line tells me that it's the same angle. And I'm going to bring it all the way up there. All right. So now I'm just going to trim out the points that I don't need. So trim by typing TR, enter, enter, TR and enter twice. So I'll trim this line. Trim out all of those points. All right. I'll trim out all of these points here. I know I have the reduction. This is my reduced figure. All right, the angles and everything are the same, but the proportions are different. proportions are at a ratio of 3 to 5. All right, now I'm going to enlarge the figure by a ratio of 8 to 5. And now in enlarging the figure, this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to measure 3 of these divisions. And the reason why I'm going to measure 3 is this. The ratio is 8 to 5. So that means we're going to extend this line out more. And 5 plus 3 would give me 8. So to get exactly where point 8 would be, I'll just measure the distance from A to 3. And that is 27. All right, that distance is 27. So if I draw a line from 5 down to 27, let me come out a construction line and use an actual solid line. All right, so let me use this line. All right, and that line is going to be 27. Let me turn on ortho since it's a vertical line. And I'm going to make this line 27. So type 27 and press enter. All right, so there we go. Now, just like we did when we were copying, we're going to do the same thing. So I'm going to copy this line. All right, and I'm going to, all right, before I do that, let me divide this line to show you that you would get 5, 6, 7 and so on. So you might understand a bit better if I divide the line and show you. If I click on the line here, it says enter the number of segments. Since we want to add 3 more, let me type 3 and press enter. So in this case, this is 5. So let me copy this. So this would be 6, 7, and then finally 8. All right, so let me label these. 6, 7, and then finally we have 0.8 right here. Good. All right, now let me just copy this. So just like we did when we copy this and bring it up, since we're enlarging, we're going to bring it down to 0.8 here. So I'm going to copy, click on the copy tool there, and I'm going to copy the line from 5, and I'm going to bring it down to that point there. All right, but as you can see, it didn't meet this line as yet, so I'm going to need to extend it. So I'm going to click on this line and just click extend and bring it out. I'll need to turn off ortho. Make sure you turn off ortho before you extend. So I'm going to click on this line again. The green line tells me that the angle is correct. It's the same angle. Then I'm going to bring it there. And then now I'm going to copy this line as well. And I'm going to copy it from point C here. And I'm going to bring it down to that point here. Let me just ensure that it actually meets the correct point. There we go, right at that end point, at the end of the line. And I'm going to extend line AD just a little. Let me turn on ortho since this is a horizontal line. So let me extend it to about there. All right. Then now I'm going to extend this line. I'm going to click on this line. I'm going to extend it by clicking here. And I have ortho turned on. Let me turn off ortho. Always turn off ortho before you extend, unless you're extending a vertical or horizontal line. And then I'm going to bring that up at that same angle to meet line AD there. And then I'm going to trim. Enter. And I'm going to trim that point right there. All right. So now this is my enlarged figure. So this figure here, A, B, C, D, this is it reduced at a ratio of 3 to 5, and enlarged at a ratio of 8 to 5. And that's about reducing or enlarging a figure using the direct method A. All right, I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, you can just leave a comment below, and you can also subscribe so that you don't miss any future content. All right, so thanks for watching, and do have yourself a wonderful day.